There's some kind of light, some kind of deeply personal beauty in this music.
Music at its best is some honest portrayal of things that we all feel.
The Dranoff International Two Piano Competition is the top competition for young professional artists from 21 to 30 that play two piano music.
Dranoff fosters the appreciation and enjoyment of two piano music.
The piano in the hands of one person is sort of an orchestra. In the hands of two people, it is an orchestra.
Two piano music is not only important, but it is one of the most engaging art forms there is, because it is the core of ensemble music, people playing together. With two human beings, two people, two instruments, that's really the very most basic of human relationships too. The Dranoff started with one of the top teams in the entire world, Murray and Loretta Dranoff. They were the first two piano team on television. And this was the model that Loretta used for shaping the Dranoff International Two Piano Competition. The core of the Dranoff Two Piano Foundation is the international competition. The final rounds are concert performances and open to the public. Almost all of the young artists that we work with come from outside the United States. It really is a competition of the top rigor, and it develops careers right there by just participation.
Competitions are how musicians in classical music really navigate through a career. They're a way to connect to the world that you're going to be going into to make this a career. A significant competition like the Dranoff has a huge role to play in terms of moving music forward. Otherwise, how does it happen? It doesn't really. It needs these things.
People view a competition for the competitors. They don't understand initially that it's a public performance opportunity where they're going to see the finest performance that happens at that time that's happening anywhere in the world. This was something that added value to the South Florida community from the very first competition that was here.
We're trying to do more and more to encourage the arts because we understand it's an important part of what we do in marketing this community. I think it's a perfect match to have that kind of international, high-level competition, well-known, world-renowned organization in the arts located in this growing business international center.
Introduced 11 new works by the greatest composers of our time.
When I was approached by the Dranoff Foundation to write an original two-piano piece for this competition, I was delighted because it's a medium that I really love. The Dranoff competition is extremely important because it's putting a medal on them. You know, this is the best. It's important.
The importance of new music creation and then dissemination, some aggregate way of getting it out there, is critical to the life of music itself.
One of the things that's so exciting about the Music in the Schools program is to bring music to people who would never have a chance to hear this world-class music, and that's primarily children.
One of the great successes that we have as a school district is the fact that there exists such great foundations like the Dranoff that are willing to come in and expose our students to world-class music. There are students that, if it were not for the Dranoff Foundation, would never be able to experience this type of art.
The fact that the Dranoff Foundation brings the music to underserved children is just critical. And what happens is it's harder to hate, it's harder to have this callousness towards other human beings. And I think it helps add up to people being more human and to getting along better.
In the last year or two or three, the competition has become recognized as the leading international competition for two pianos in the world. There are preliminary rounds taking place all over the world, and so that builds up to the final rehearsal and concert week here in Miami. There's tremendous sense of excitement, and I've noticed that the friends of the competition and the audience members really have the opportunity to identify with the contestants, and they feel with them their hopes and their aspirations and their disappointments, and if they don't win, they weep with them. And there's this indefinable sense of a star or a pair of stars being born overnight.
Throughout my career at AT&T in Miami, we sought opportunities to share our brand with world-class institutions for customer entertainment, for branding purposes, and to show that we wanted to support the best in the arts. We found it with Dranoff, just that good.
The Murray Dranoff Foundation, with worldwide recognition of its international piano competition, is a superb example of a cultural endowment gone well.
I think that when you support something like this in a very subtle way, you're making the world a better place, and that's everything.
Be not forgetful of the needs of the spirit. We've got to find room to support and enhance the cultural arts.
It's all about values. It's what we value about the quality of our life. What would we like for ourselves? People can be part of this today, but they're really investing in the future of the music and the art itself, and they're investing in the people that they want to be around them for their lives, their own children, and what's going to go on beyond that.